line. Finally, yeah. 7:30 p.m. Can I have a music line? I check, please. Awesome. Music. Famous Baru volcano in the heart of Vulcan City lies this beautiful geisha that is growing on a stunning high altitude of 1,500 meters above sea level on the rich fertile soil. With such cooling temperatures and high elevation, this will provide a slow maturation of coffee cherries, which will lead us to a sweeter coffee. Antonio Vesquez and his family have been harvesting ground deeply for the past 170 years and over four generations, where they call this their home and life. Sounds good, isn't it? The pursuit for perfection has been a common practice in our industry, looking for the best coffee, best processing methods, best roast profile, or even the prettiest latte art. Unfortunately for me, I believe that perfection does not exist. So why do we strive so hard to attain perfection? The answer is simple. In this case, Antonio Vesquez's mission is to strive for excellence in coffee processing and of course put food on the table for his family. So today it's an honor for me to serve you this work. Let's taste it. The judges are only pulling signature beverage espressos. That we are going to experience in this restaurant. I'll be right back. So, before sipping this beverage, I have a few drinking instructions for you. I will need you to take the spoons. After your crema evaluation, I will need you to take the spoons and dig it deep back and forth for about 10 times. This is to incorporate all those layers together. And further cooling down the espresso, as it will open up to a much bigger flavor. Next, take in those aromatic evaluation. You will note that orange blossom and a prominent sweet jasmine in the aroma. Followed by taking two good sips. On the first sip, like what I mentioned just now, that massively intense bright cherry, followed by intricate apricot sweetness. And on the second sip, juicy mouthfeel, medium weight, clean and lingering pleasant grapefruit finish. Please enjoy. There are more references about Antonio's coffee in front of you. Please feel free to read for him. Judges, when you're ready, please flip the page in front of you to the back page. As you can see, the roast profile for my coffee and also the taste profile for the milk beverage. For you. So when you receive this beverage, I will need you to basically stir it really, really well. So in order for the milk and the coffee to balance really well. Two good sips on the first sip. Note that really, really creamy top coffee mouthfeel,
followed by the
sweetness of
espresso.
Cherry pie milk.
Really covered,
On the second sip, the body of milk chocolate that comes out really, really nicely with a pleasant tarty pie crust at the end. So just in front of you, there are two different roast profiles and also the tasting notes for this coffee. Please feel free to read it, as I'll explain to you further. me and my roaster have worked really hard to achieve these two roast profiles, which I feel that it works really well for the geisha. We have equally blend two different developments of 18% after first crack to achieve its acidity and clarity for this coffee. And a 19% after first crack, just to caramelize all those sugars and further lifting up the body for this coffee. I've also chosen this beautiful 4-ounce cup because I feel that I really want the coffee to have a bigger show as the milk does. Stir it really well and take it to a good sip. Like what I said just now, creamy toffee mouthfeel with cherry pie fillings. On the second sip, you'll get that really nice sweet milk chocolate body with a tart pie crust at the end. Enjoy. So I've been asking myself what really defines the perfect signature beverage. To me, the perfect signature beverage will definitely need to raise the whole experience for this coffee to a whole different level by enhancing all those flavors together and give us a whole new experience for this coffee. So let's start, yeah? Water for all. Okay, I'm going to aerate this chilled espresso which I pulled just now together with 40 ml of sparkling water. Aerate it with a high-speed blender, and this will give us a creamy mouthfeel with a sparkling aftertaste for the signature beverage. I'll be right back.
Oh yeah, okay. Aku tak boleh pakai aku dari pom-pom. Come on. Thai iced tea, yeah.
Next, we are going to build this beverage cup. First up, basically, adding 5 ml of soft dulce de leche, which is basically a reduction of brown sugars, milk, and bicarbonate soda, which I made painfully yesterday night. This is just basically to represent the mouthfeel and body for this beverage. As well for the dark cherry reduction, the sugars in this cherry is just to bind all these flavors together and further lifting up the body and sweetness and reminisces us for what our espresso tastes just now. Time check.
Okay, I tried to cut short this one, sir. Go, faster.
Next, topping up this aerated espresso to conclude the beverage.
Faster. Come on, Ayat.
Come on!
So I need favor once again to basically stir it really well before taking two good sips. On the first sip, you'll get those toffee creamy mouthfeel followed by a very nice pleasant aroma of cherry with the sweetness of that cherry that we remind of us of that espresso just now. And on the second sip, you'll get those nice, sweet, delicate sweetness of grapefruit and also that pleasant acidity.
So
with that, I call for time.
Yeah.
to get there for me.